Joshua Abaho, the personal assistant to the Minister of Karamoja Affairs, this morning turned himself in at the anti-corruption court in Kololo, where Minister Kitutu and her brother were appearing for the mention of their case. He was arraigned before the Chief Magistrate, Joanna Chiro, and officially charged with the loss of public property and corruption on the same file, where Kitutu and her brother, Michael Naboya Kitutu, were previously charged and granted bail. Abaho pleaded innocent to both charges, and prosecution informed the court that inquiries into the matter are still on.
Inquiries are still ongoing. We pray for another mention date.
Immediately, Abaho's lawyer, led by Paul Kutesa, applied for bail on grounds that he is innocent and the charges against him are bailable by the anti-corruption court. He presented five sureties, including Kenneth Mugumia Tibeijuka, the assistant commissioner in the Ministry of Education, Johnson Musinguzi, the assistant commissioner, Minister of Works and Transport, Geoffrey Ndualana, the engineer for Machinde Sabagao Municipality Council, Simon Peter Kasiate, the KCCA head of corporate affairs, plus Simon Tumwesije Karokora, the customs supervisor at Uganda Revenue Authority.
From accused person number two, to apply to you, Your Honor, to release him on bail, pending the hearing and determination of the charges against him. Admit the applicant satisfies the considerations for grant of bail in circumstances such as the one he's faced with. Your Honor, the accused person, prior to these charges, has never been charged with any other criminal offense.
However, prosecution led by David Bisamunyu and Jonathan Mwaganya said they were served with the documents of Abaho on Wednesday and did not have time to peruse through them. They objected to the bail application, arguing that the presented sureties are non-substantial and do not have the capacity to meet the bond terms, considering their earning as shown by their bank statements. Chief Magistrate Achiro adjourned the case to May 2nd, and remanded Abaho to Ruzira Prison. Also, Kitutu and her brother Naboya's case mention were adjourned till then.
Financial documents of these sureties shows you that these are not people who will be able to meet the terms of the bond. Whether they be disregarded, they've not demonstrated that capacity. So the statements show, as maybe most public servants, they're either paying back loans or just living, really. But if they were told to pay 200 million shillings, if you look at the statements, Your Worship, the bank statements which are attached, the balances do not demonstrate that capacity at all.
Abaho is the fourth suspect to be charged in the Iron Sheets scandal. The others are Minister Kitutu, her brother Naboya, Minister for Finance and Economic Planning Amos Logolobi, and the State Minister for Karamoja Affairs Agnes Nandutu, who is still on remand. Prosecution states that during the month of June 2022, at the office of the Prime Minister's stores in Namamve in Mukono District, being in a public office in the position of Senior Assistant Secretary for the Minister of Karamoja Affairs, Abaho diverted 9,000 iron sheets of gauge 28 belonging to the state. The prosecution further contends that in the month of January 2023, Abaho also diverted 5,500 iron sheets meant for the Karamoja Community Empowerment Program. Report compiled by Rachel Nachiwala for the news.